Alright guys, resistive circuit number two. So now we've got a series circuit. We got three different resistive elements. We got 100 ohms, 330, and 470. So we've dropped those guys down into our chart here. I find the chart's nice because it kind of organizes your thoughts. But if you have a different way of doing it, then stick with what works. So let's see. We can't take that 120 and put it across everything because that 120 goes here and here. And so that voltage is obviously dropped across R1, R2, and R3. So Kirchhoff's law is that the sum of these voltage drops will equal the source at 120. So we can't do anything with that voltage yet. We don't have any current. We're stuck finding the total resistance. Not so dirty though, because the resistance with this guy is just the fact that we have current flowing in one direction. It's going to smack into each of these guys before it gets back to the source. So all we have to do is just add up those guys to find our total resistance. So RT here is going to be 100 ohms plus the 330 ohms plus the 470 ohms. So total resistance for these guys is going to be 900 ohms. Beauty. So then if we want to keep track of everything, then we know easy now. This one's going to be 900 ohms, and we're going to drop 120 volts across that 900 ohms. So take your calculator out, do the 120 divided by 900, and it gives you, let's drop in that 900 here, gives you 0.133333 repeating amps. So we'll keep three decimal places so everybody's on the same page here. And now that current we said goes all the way through that circuit, right? Let's just drop this here. Some people like to have the Ohm's law charts all the way around so we can keep track of all of our elements. So that goes through everything in the circuit because we have a series circuit. Beauty. Okay, let's get rid of this to make some room. So this guy right here for R1. We don't know the voltage yet. We do know that there is 100 ohms and there is 0.133 amps flowing through that guy. So if we take the 0.133 amps, multiply it by the 100 ohms, that is going to give us 13.3 volts dropped across the first resistor. Nice. Now we got everything for the first resistor. Let's do the next one. R2 has 330, same current, 0.133 amps. Beauty. So take your calculator out, go 0.133 amps times 330, and that gives you 43.89 volts. Okay, last one. 470 ohms, same current, it's a series circuit, 0.133 amps. So we'll take the 0.133 amps, multiply it by the 470, and that gives us 62.51 volts. Beauty. Now, you can just double check that by taking your each of your individual voltages. Right, so for the first one, we have 13.3 plus the 43.89 plus the 62.51. Gorgeous. Took off a few decimal places there, right? Because that's 0.1333 repeating. So when we add up all those individual voltages that we have here, it gives me 119.7. That's close enough for Canada. Beautiful. Okay, now we got to find all our total powers here and our individual powers. Let's just start over here. 62.51 times 0.133 amps gives me 8.31 units for power or watts, because we're just doing resistors right now. Next one, 43.89 times 0.133 amps gives me 5.84 watts. And again, 13.3 times 0.133 amps gives me 1.77 watts. And then our total, if we take the 0.133 times 900, that gives me 15.96 watts. Let's just double check. Let's add up all of our power values and make sure that it adds to the total. So 1.77 plus 5.84 plus 8.31 gives me 15.92. And I found 15.96 by multiplying the current times the resistance. Beauty. Looks good. Excellent. I think we found everything there, guys. If you find different answers, again, it's because you've used less or more decimal places than I have here. And remember that even individual calculators are going to give you different values, right? Remember those guys, each of the calculators have different components in, the components have different tolerances, so even different calculators are going to give you different answers. All right, guys, we'll stop here. Click on to number 3 and we'll move on.